Hallo.
Hallo, alles. Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Hendrik Jager. Just get this out of the way. Welcome to our webinar. There are lots of people registered. We are 28 on the list that's registered. We're only four at the moment. Michiel is here, Nico is here. My welcome, Alice and David. Let me take this away. Please, if you want us to look at certain specific shares, give me a shout, put them in the chat box. Talk to me, tell me, Skalk, we give it lastly. Now, first things first, we're going to look at the J203, the Jersey All Share. And now we've been in a sideways channel for a long time. 10th of February. Okay, so yeah, we're drifting sideways. And if we're not going up, then we're going down. We tried up, we tried down, we tried up, we tried, now trying down again. Okay. And the problem is that you do see is that the moving average are starting to turn negative. Okay. So the market is in a decline mode, an adjustment mode, call it what you want. It does give sell bicycles here at the bottom in the green quarter. But yes, it's not necessary that you should start to buy. Okay, this is the Jersey All Share. All the shares on the exchange. Now, just a quick recap. Brent crude is only share that, well, the only commodity that did exceptionally well. We've rushed through this Fibonacci. We're now at $75.62 to the barrel. Brent did very well. Okay, so the only share that could really benefit from that at the moment is Sasol. And Sasol is not performing that bad. But let's start with the top 40. Let's work through some shares until you give me shares to look at that I can look at for you. There we got a list. There's a question mark. Michiel is hier. Ja. Michiel. Wat wil je met jullie doen? Oké, we'll get to that just now, Michiel. Let me just look at some of these shares. And then I want to rather work on a weekly, month, not monthly, weekly. To work on a weekly chart. Because I've been contemplating this on a weekly chart since Monday. When we had our meeting Monday, we got high, then we got lower highs. Now, so we got this line there on Monday, and then we opened below this, and then we had a negative breakout. We touched base with this trend line that I got here, this trend coming from here. There's a long-term trend line there. The trend was up, obviously, all those other places as well, but it's now here. You can, in fact, put a trend line there. All that it matters. Okay, so at the moment we're on the trend line. We take that low, and then this week's so far today's low or closing price. There you got it. So we tend, if we remain at this place in time, then coming next week, we're going to have a further negative breakout. We'll have a continuance of the negativity. Okay, just for interest sake, we take a second line there, take a red line. Then take note that over the long term, doesn't matter what you do, we're still in a negative tendency. The negative tendency accelerated here, but it is a continuance. If we can pick up on this trend, then there will be a consolidation. We're going to move into a corner. We can break out top side, we can break out bottom side. But as I said before, as for the Jersey All Share, the moving averages are starting to turn negative. Now, the moving averages will follow it negatively, or we can maintain a base. They will come down and they'll pick it up and pick up the share, and we can have a continuance. Okay, But the all these cycles, it's not bad. It's a good thing. Nothing can just go up and up and up. Things must come down so that we can all have an opportunity to invest. Now, BHP Billiton, excellent share. We looked at it on Monday, and it opened below this trend line. We just pushed through all the lines. Okay. So irrespective. So I'm going to take some of this, one of this. I'll just say take that one, and I'm going to take this one away. Take that one away. And I can just leave this one there. And take that one away. And I'll take all these others away. We've looked at this shape many times. Okay. Now what we have? We had a base trend there. The base trend was there. We broke through it. Now, if we leave it like that, we both broke back to the top side of it. We started to on the median here for the 50% line between the pulse or the overbought and oversold barrier, and then it seems like Billiton wants to get on board. Billiton still doesn't matter. It's got a dividend yield of 4.8, excellent dividend returns, P of 14, the price is good. And it is not a bad share, but yeah, you got to buy in the direction of the trend. Now the trend is up, you buy it at in the dips, okay? Just find out where the dips is, so that you do not buy yourself a share that's going to dip further after you bought it. Now Richmond did exceptionally well. Richmond came out of all these. Richmond, if you take this low, then this week we sort of stuck here. If you want to put a line there, you're welcome. Put a line there, it's actually be a support line, not a red line, but doesn't matter. So it seems like after this huge growth, we have a consolidation. We're heavily overbought. Well, we got been overbought since we had this huge rise. Now there should be a consolidation, people taking profit, maintaining balance, maintaining a price level. And then we can go further. Okay, if you look at BHP Billiton, since when was this? This was November 2020. Okay, but there was lots of growth since then. You want to see, just for interest sake, let us make a measure there. Where it is now, it's 71%. That's not bad. Since November last year to now, it's not bad, not bad at all. But it seems like we're going to maintain a price level here. Normally, a previous high is a strong support. It's not really breaking through that level yet, but that should be the line. That should be the level. Okay, there. Now I'm using the wrong tool. Sorry, we do it right. Could that should be the support. So we should go on from there. I think it should maintain somewhere a place that it can drift sideways. Okay, now we looked at Anglo. Just get started off some of these slides. Let me do the refresher that you can follow with me. Okay. What I want to show you. Now we got a support there, we got a low here, and we got an uptrend. The uptrend was there. This low, that opening price, this closing price. Then we went below this week, we opened below this line, so we had a negative breakout, and we are pursuing upwards. So if you come from the top, there you've got the high, and you've got lower highs, you've got a negative tendency. I can perhaps just see if I can put that one there. I've got the Fibonacci, the 100%, that's where we want to go back to. The low, this is where we was. We opened below, but we let's leave it at that. This is not a vested low yet. We can use this low if you want to. This low, doesn't matter, it will all be fine. That found resistance there against it and found support on it. Find resistance, find support on it, pulled on that level, came back, broke that level, broke all the levels, and sort of came down there with the slugs. Now, basically, what you should also take in mind is the gold price. Please note the gold price. The gold price came down heavily from this upward there, came all the way down. This is this, they call it, I posted it on Telegram as a bearish railway tracks, indicating further south movement perhaps next month. We'll have to wait and see, but there's not good prospects for gold at the moment. Now, this should nicely push back. If it can clear this negative trend line, then we can have further upside. We can have a continuation of this trend line. Yeah. Okay, this was not bad. It started there in 23 March last year. It was not a bad growth, but yes, we need to get on the upside of this negative trend line. Otherwise, this negative trend line can just force it further negative. This is now this week, next week, and the week thereafter. So somewhere in the next 3 weeks, you need to be back on this line, otherwise you're going negative. Okay, there's the moving averages. I've got the 20, the 50, the 100, and the 200. The other basic ones, you like to catch a share when it's on the 50-day moving average. The 50-day moving average is the baseline. 50-day moving average. Catch it on the moving average, and you'll be okay. Catch it on the moving average, always just when it breaks through the moving average positively, like here. Beautiful. Catch it there. And then it bounced on the 20, then it again bounced on the 20 way. Now it's again on the 50. It did likewise on the 50 year again. See, the moving averages are beautiful, beautiful indicators, but remember they follow the curve. No, it sounds like COVID. They follow the curve. So, and then if the share starts to move up, then the moving average will follow only later. But it can cross up over and above this average anytime. So a proper cross indicates a buy signal. Proper cross negative indicates a sell signal. Okay, so please take that in mind with trend lines, with the indicators. You've got a global picture that can really benefit you. We looked at first round as well on the weekly chart. We have a longer term, or a couple of weeks, though, 1, 2, 3, 4 weeks perhaps, negative tendency. We've got this upward, we've actually got a huge sideways here that we broke out. Let me take some of these lines out here. Let me do this. Please take note, this is important that you know, that you recognize these patterns. Perhaps there. Or you can, if you want, you can put it there. But the bulk of the movement was there between these two Fibonacci levels, the 50 and the 23.6. Okay, so it's either above or below. And now it's in this block again. So there's no real, and this also is a spinning top with a negative tendency with a red. Okay, so it might indicate that it can go further south. But this is now also a weekly chart. Remember, this weekly chart can go both ways still tomorrow and Friday. So lots of things can happen. The indicator says we're going down. So let's do that. Just for interest sake, let's just look at Impala and Sibanye. Now, if you had these lines before, we had this low, then we had a beautiful trend line, then we broke out of the trend line. So we started making lower highs. Now the trend has changed, lower lows, the trend has changed. We're going down. And then if you want to, there was a backup trend line there, it also broke through. There was a, on this line also, there was another line. You can use whatever lines you can find that connects the most dots. You can use that, if you use that eye and see where this trend line was, then perhaps the trend line was there as a better, it's a better line, because I got this, I almost got that, I got those two highs, got the closing price, got this closing price. So we are here, okay. But in itself, you can also just draw another line from there, connect those dots, because obviously they're also rendering resistance. Now, for argument's sake, we this line that with this opening price, that opening of that high price there, we're pushing against this now for the week. Okay, so tomorrow, if we can have a continuous, we'll have a breakout, and we have an opening price next week that can follow suit here, that can continue, that can give us some upward thrust. Okay, but wait, it's still under the line, don't get involved. Sorry, just busy with something else there on the slide line. Okay, so this is Impala Platinum, but now also Impala Platinum got this huge candle because why of this? And it's not really a good sign. It's take it as you like. But we had a huge plunge. Now we had a slight pullback. Yeah, we have the slight pullback that indicates that, well, that's not driving the platinum price on the share, but we was there and then we came down. So it's really, where's the month? You see, we're in the month of, see, this is June. June starts here. And then we have this plunge. And now we're starting to pick back up. That's why there's a reversal now. Because of the platinum price sort of came back from the heavy dip. Okay, so we can have if a platinum price continues, then we can catch this trend line here as a direction or a guidance, and then we can pick up on it. And perhaps you can go back where it was. So this can be a good sign, this can be a good signal, but you need a closing and a confirmation. Okay, do not get involved. We opened below the line because, and that indicated a further drawdown with the platinum. Of course, the platinum reversed that. Same with SSW, Sibanye. We got the same scenario with Sibanye. Exactly the same scenario with Sibanye. Okay, so you can put it where you want. I'd like to put it there. If I put it there, then we can have a continuance of this trend line next week. We can get out from underneath this negative line. We can go back up again. There's a long negative tendency there from far away. Okay, that indicates future. Let me use that one. That one is, I've got 2 points there, 1, 2 points there. Would have liked to use this one, but it's too far down. Because if we can pick up here, we'll have a consolidation, and perhaps we can have a breakout to the top. We're really on the 50 level here, beautiful, on the 50 moving average. Beautiful place to look at shares for a buy. You can go back in history and look at them everywhere where there was there for a good buy. Okay. Indication was that in history will always repeat itself. Now, okay, I'm going to stop here. I'm going to look at these shares that Gil gave me. Hello, Skalk. MSM, let's look at MSM, Massmart, our favorite shopping center. That's what we got so many lines here. Let me just delete some of them. I can draw this further. Can just extend that one. Okay, so you got this beautiful growth. Look at this. Ay, ay, ay. When was this again? August, the 11th of August, week of the 11th of August. There, so since then, we had this beautiful drive. And the current is down at 239% for a year. How beautiful is that? How beautiful is that? Isn't that super cool? Now remember, in all of these instances, let's do that. Or let's leave it like that because it was a resistance. It became a support afterwards. Yeah, you got this beautiful breakout. That bicycle. That bicycle was not there when this was there. Don't fool yourself. It only came later when this candle pulled it. Okay. But irrespective, that breakout was there. You could have seen that. You could have witnessed that. Your confirmation came later. You know, as well, where we are now, we've got this top in there. Got this negative tendency here. Now, as soon as it finds a bottom, and now, as I said earlier, a previous high is normally a good support level. See, a previous high is normally a good support level. Seems like it's pulling back from these levels, pulling back from these levels. Okay, so, and the thrust is now against that. But now, so this is also a weekly chart. So give it a break. Okay, this is this week, this is next week. If it opens where it closed, if it closes where it closes now, then you'll have a breakout. We can have an uplink. Okay, don't rush these things. Like, give them space. Let them do what they do and follow through and have a good trade. Let's do this. Should be on that level. If we open next week, we can bounce here and we can have a continuation. Okay, but we need to get out from underneath this line. This line, if it pulls back, it can open here. You can have a negative further. Okay, so it needs to open close to the line as possible so that it can open above the line. But that's for next week. So don't buy it now because it can still pull back and open here below the line next week. So leave it, let it really dry. Give it space. Okay. Our market has been very negative. Some of these shares are actually really pulling back strongly against the negative sentiment of the market. Okay, so MSM is not looking bad, but give it space. Let's look for the scenario where there's a breakout. Okay, for the scenario where there's a breakout, and then you'll have a proper weekly prospect of positive movement. Okay, not just too much noise from the daily chart. I hope it makes sense. I don't know. Now we've looked at the SSW. Let's look at let's delete these. Okay, then if you look at the chart, what do you see? You see you've got a high, but lower high. So you've got a negative tendency as a resistance. Okay, so you got there a resistance. Now we pulled back strongly, we closed below the line, we opened below the line, we said that we can come back to the line, we did come back to the line, but we can still open below this line and have a negative fallout. Okay, not to say that we need to close above some of these lines. And this is a strong line. It's got two strong points. So it's a strong resistance as well. To follow go back up. We need to get above this line. Or old Mox will fight with me if I say draw the lines through the candles. You can put it there, but then you miss so much information, okay? Because now we don't ever want to have a pullback back to this line. We want to have a pullback back to this line, to this trend. It is just the wheel that needs to turn. But anyway, we can close above this trend line. So this, we need to see some further movement for the week still, so that we can open above. So we need to go about to the 50% level, to the 50% level of the Fibonacci. Then you can have we can expect a positive opening next month. But this is just a huge negative. If it goes back there, then we can as well fall back down. But this seems like it can have a positive break. If we got a negative, we got a positive, we can have a positive. Okay. Let's follow it and see what comes out of it. But we need to get above this negative tendency line. It doesn't matter which way you look at it. We need to get above that negative tendency line. Okay. Michiel, maak het weer sin, broer. Verstaan jy dit? Talk to me. Let me hear what you say. What do you think? Skalk, jy sê niks. Okay, so then we can just continue with Mondi. We looked at Mondi. Mondi has had some positivity, but not a huge, it's like a slow coach with huge volatility, huge red candles, green, red, green, fish. It's not really that it wants to go in a direction. We're trying to, but it's a very slow go. So you can very easily detect the channel here. So just want to adjust that one now. Can easily detect the channel here. I can just want to put that one there. Perhaps a bit lower. Okay, so you have a channel here. And we are sort of just wanting to get back in this channel. Okay, let me make it bigger. Okay, we're just wanting to get back into this channel now. We got this eye, then it was there. Really was there. And then we opened there, we had a good run, thought it was a breakout, we had a good run. People got involved, they climbed and they bought it right at the top there. And where are they now? Then it fell right in out of the bus. One shot last week. And then the open deer is trying to recuperate, coming back. Red, green, red, green. These are just speculative points. They lure you, they buy it, and you see, yes, this was definitely a breakout. Let me go with, and you'll buy it from them. They take the money and they put it in their pockets. Okay, be careful for that. Okay, so we need to get back into this channel. We need to get out from under which line? There's a long-term negative line that we still need to get through. We still need to get through that, like to really go back to the top, to go back to that those levels. We're not there yet. We're not there yet at all. You can indicate as much positivity here as well. The share is not going to do it. Okay, now this is not, if this was the closing price for the week, then you could have drawn a line there. But you cannot. It's not a closing price. It can do anything yet. That's not necessarily the closing price. We're using the Fibonacci for this previous high, and we got this previous low. Perhaps this low is a bit weird. It's a bit far. See, this low is not a breasted low, it's not closed yet. Okay, so it can still fall back and go beyond. So we only got these levels. You need to work with closed candles. Okay, then, but look at these levels. Trying to get through, touching that level for the week so far. If it can go back there, that will be so wonderful. Then it makes it very much easier to get through this barrier layer. Okay, but that's Monday. As for the last, perhaps MTN and Standard Bank. Standard also came huge down with a huge plunge. We got this still negative trend there. And you see, I can't use this. This is not a fixed level. This is not a fixed price level. So you cannot use it. It might entice you to look at it, but you cannot, because it can still do anything, but it's in a huge. It can go there, it can go here, it can go anywhere. It's not really going in any direction. Standard Bank is not doing good, and the indicator says that it should come down further. Look at this huge candle. We're going to overtake this candle. It needs to pass more than 50% of this candle before you can have a turnaround. And it's not going there yet, so the tendency is still very much down. It's below this 50% level. Okay, I hope it makes sense for you guys. MTN, favorite, look at it, beautiful. Beautiful, look at this. Every time it got this ball, flag, then we got a small ball, small flag, a small ball, and a smaller flag. Then you got a nice ball. Okay, so. One of these lines doesn't really matter anymore because it's past tense. But in any case, if you just look at these, the bicycles, there. Use as many points as you can. Okay, now, for prey, I'm using that eye, this opening price, that eye. Okay, so see where you can draw the most points. That should be the most points there. This high, this closing price, and then this opening. Okay, but it was in the clouds already for a long time. And it's still going strong. It pulled back from this line this morning. Look where the moving averages are. They're so far behind. They're not even in the picture. Look at the pointing, the direction, which directions these moving averages are pointing. Beautiful. So MTN is by not finished by a long shot still. There's still lots of opportunities here. There's no real happening here. You can, if you want to use, you can use that line. But you cannot use this eye yet, because that eye doesn't exist. It's there, but it can go past through. That will just kick you. So you've got to wait for it to do its thing. Wait for it to come around. Okay, so that's MTN. It's not really that bad. PBX, for those of you who want to look at process, right, lots of things happening with process. It's not really anyway, so process this candle. It's just busy with the candle, so you cannot use the candle. But there, you look at this line coming from the top. That highs, all these highs, that opening price, these highs. So really a strong line. This high, this low, and this low. It's picking up on this line, so it's really wanting the clock to turn. Okay. So if you take that same eye there and you use this eye, that gives us almost a place where it opened, and it opened below this line. Okay. If you use the high, I'm using the high. use the opening price, then perhaps you can have a different picture. But this is where we are. We need to get above this line. We need to get above this line, and we need to get above these moving averages, preferably. Where's there's the 50. Yeah, the 50 is so far away. So, but the 50 will come and pick it up. If you want to wait, you gotta wait for it. The 50 is not there. The 50 will still come and pick it up. People, I can apply the same rules to all the shares that we got here, and I would like you to really take note and go home and draw a few lines and see if you can make sense of it. Nobody taught me this, and they did not teach this. You can see, go and find, if you can find pictures on this. Yeah, everybody does trend lines, but not on a small scale. On a small scale, the rules still apply. So have a nice evening. Thank you very much for joining. Is there any other notes here? Yes? Scott said, if K2 is off. Okay, Alice is my off, Scott. Sorry. You see what's happening is that the Federal Reserve wants to combat inflation. They want to allow to raise interest rates. If they start to raise interest rates, then the money will go from the exchange to the banks, to the money sector. Okay, because it's a safer bet. It's risk-free. But as long as the money market doesn't pay 0% interest, everybody dumps their money in the exchange. Okay. That's why the exchanges are as high as they are. But if the scenario changes, with interest rates going back up again, the money will flow back from the exchanges into the money markets. Then we'll have a correction in the bourses of the world. Okay. But thank you. That's just my take on things. Okay, have a nice evening. Be safe, please. Take care.